Hello there, fellow chip writer, over here. This is take two. I rambled a little bit too much on the last video. At the housekeeping, I'm smoking my Soren, and I call it Soren, although it's Mark Refjerg, mainly because Soren is easier to pronounce. I've been away from the tube for quite a while. I'm going to use exactly the same excuse that everyone else uses, and it's been very busy. I'm now fighting a cold, remaining of a cold. I'm almost on the other side now. Enjoying a lovely bowl of 1Q, as many of you might know. I really enjoy this man. Alright, this is going to be a response, and Veronica wants to jump in my lap. This is going to be a video response to Jay in the last video that I saw from him. Stop! Oh, come on. And it was about violence. Does violence really works? And the answer, of course, has to be yes, it does. It does work. For example. Yeah, calm down. It's effective, and I will argue as well that it is effective. Can you get by means of violence what you want? It depends, but in general, I will say yes, you can. And that's why it's so common to use it, and not only for humans, but all over the animal kingdom. I mean, violence is the way to go. It's almost too easy. And that, I would say, is my counter-argument. Not that it's too easy, but it's efficiency. If we go into the details of violence, of uses of violence, I'm sure we can find plenty of examples in which it is not only effective, but also efficient. But I think in general terms, its efficiency is dull in the following sense. It's almost always like an arm race. If you're violent, you might obtain what you're looking for a brief period of time until your counterpart has the means to be violent or to respond accordingly to what you did. And that's going to be a never-ending process. Just strike, they strike back. Just strike, they strike back. And history has taught us that that's basically the rule, how it goes, for generations. Unless, even more so, when you are in the moral dilemma of how much violent you can be. If you exterminate everyone else that thinks different from you, that opposed to whatever you think or whatever you want, of course you're going to have whatever you want and whatever you want to do, and it's going to be more or less everlasting. But then you have that problem of how much violent you can be, and that's a moral problem. I would say that that's the weakest point in terms of its efficiency, and it is how everlasting is, since it depends entirely of who is in the position of power, and if that is challenged, then it's very weak, it's very unstable. If you look for other means to find that you want, that are not violent, that are supported by reason and logic, or even emotions, but emotions that are not a spin-off of violence, nor anger or revenge, but compassion or love, if you wanna use it, then it's gonna reach longer and further. At least that's what I believe. Okay, I think that's enough, and I hope I extend my answer of the just yes that I said. Yes, it works. It works, but it depends, I guess. All right. That's all for me. That's all with my friends. Bye-bye.